in terms of achieving its goals through marketing. That's marketing objective. That means whatever activity you have to do to enable you to reach your goals in terms of marketing your business. That's what we call marketing objective. So, say, so marketing objectives are procedures firms go through to achieve their marketing goals. Mm-hmm. So what are their marketing goals? Let's say, okay, what are those things we need to achieve in terms of marketing our business? Mm-hmm. Why do we even have to market our business? One of the reasons why you have to market your business is to increase your market share. Another reason is to build a reputation for your business. And the last one is to increase your revenue. So these are three reasons why a business must think of marketing. Are you with me? So here, so we said marketing objectives are procedures firms go through to achieve their marketing goals. So the goals would be 1, increase market share. What is market share? Market share is your total brand sales divided by your total market sales times 100. That's the market sale. So when you talk about how to increase your market share, that means in a very competitive market, you want your product to be the highest sold product in that market. So that means, let's say in the market of laptops, you want your own brand business to be the highest they buy. That's how you increase your market share. Why do you want to have a large market share? When you have a large market share, it means your business is growing. It means your market is growing. And when your business is growing, what happens? You will be able to enjoy economies of scale because you are producing more. The larger your market share, the more product you have, the more your output is. And when your output increases, it means you are able to enjoy economies of scale. And what's the economies of scale here? Economies of scale means an advantage you have, a cost advantage you have as a result of increasing your output. Mm-hmm. Do you get it? So firms are considering increasing their market share so that they can enjoy economies of scale. Because the only way you can enjoy economies of scale is when you are producing a larger output. Mm-hmm. And to produce a larger output, it means you have increased your market share in the market. That means your product is what everyone is looking for. Your product is what every customer wants to buy. Then you have to produce more. That means your business is growing. You just start to increase the market share here. So the first thing about market share is, for market share itself, market share equals total brand sales over total market sales. This is the formula for market share. So now, the information about market share, I said, for firms will tend to increase their market share so that they can increase their output. As a result, they will be able to enjoy economies of scale. Is it clear? So firms
So,
firms tend to increase their market share as it allows them to increase their output, and as a result, they enjoy what we call economies of scale. What's economies of scale? I told you, economies of scale mean and a cost advantage a business has as a result of increasing output. Is it clear? So, economies of scale.
Economies of scale.
So, economies of scale is a cost advantage as a result of a business increasing its output. Do you understand? So, when you increase your output, you wouldn't want to increase your output as a business if your business, if your product is not selling in the market. But if your product is selling in the market, that means your business is the one, it's, your product is what customers want to buy. That's why you want to produce further. And in the cost of you producing further, that means you have to increase your output. And by increasing your output, you need more raw materials, you need more products. And this means you can buy on a larger scale. And buying on a larger scale will lead to what we call economies of scale. A cost advantage as a result of a business increasing its output, or a cost reduction. Do you understand? Is it clear, please? So, the second reason why there's need for a business to make up a marketing objective is to increase revenue. To increase revenue. To increase revenue, what does that mean? It means you want your sales. You want to increase the level of your sales. You want to increase the levels of the level of your sales. That means you want to sell more. Because it's the only way you sell more, you can make more profit. So the higher your revenue, the higher the profit you could make as a business. So one of the reasons why you are setting a marketing objective is because you want to make profit. But to reach profit, you need to increase what your revenue. Do you understand? Yes. Because it's only when you have a higher revenue or a high revenue that you can think of a high profit. Is it clear?
Yes.
So this implies that a business is aiming at a higher profit, but a higher profit cannot be reached without a higher revenue. Is it clear? The third reason, to improve the brand sale, to increase the brand sale,
please, to build the brand image.
So, building a brand image, what does it imply? It implies a business trying to create a unique selling point for itself, trying to build a reputation for itself, trying to make a name for its products. So, that is one of the reasons why there's need for a marketing objective. Do you understand?
Sure.
A business trying to make a name for itself.
to build a brand image, that's the third marketing objective. It implies that a business is trying to make a name for itself. This could be done by creating a brand name and financing and finding a unique selling point. Creating a product differential. You have to make your product different from others.
Exactly.
That's what we mean by building a brand image. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
And the last thing, for your business to have a successful marketing objective, your business must be smart. So, for our business to have a successful marketing objective, it must be smart. So when we talk about be smart here, we're talking about one, it must be specific. One, it must be specific. It must be measurable. It must be agreed. It must be realistic. And it was the time specific. So, you don't just come up with a business objective when you are not specific about what you really want to become. You have a target. So, what does this target want to reach? What do you want to become with setting up this target? You have to be specific about it. Oh, well, this has to be done within 5 days. It has to be 5 days. That means you are specific. Or we need to build a marker. We need to build a blue marker. So you are specific about what you want to do. That means you are being specific. Two, you have to measure the risk that it takes to set up this objective. Three, you have to agree. It's not just going to be you alone. It has to come with everyone agreeing on that specific objective. Then you have to be realistic. You have to tell yourself the truth. Mm-hmm. You have to understand that this, there's no other way around it than putting it right. And the last one, it has a duration. It must start now and end now. It must start now and end then. It must be for 5 days. It must start from Sunday and end on Saturday. Mm-hmm. It must start from today and end after tomorrow. Mm-hmm. You have to be time specific. So this is the only way you can have what a successful marketing objective. Is it clear?
Mm-hmm.
Any questions? It applies stages. The stages are products passes through over time, and it's expected. Sales. So when we talk about product life cycle, it means the stages at which a product will pass through with the expected sales from that product over a period of time. That's what we call a product life cycle. So the product life cycle starts from one. These are the stages of the product life cycle. The next stage is the product life cycle. Let's try to draw product life cycle here. This is a stage and produced. This is when a product is researched and produced. Mm-hmm. Do you understand? At this point in time, you think of launching the product. And the product will be introduced to the market. Mm-hmm. At this point in time, sales are not expected to be as high as you would think for different reasons. One, the prices at which you sell for the product might be too high, okay, that customers might feel they don't want to buy it. Mm-hmm. Two, customers might not trust the kind of product you are introducing to the market. Mm-hmm. And three, you might have set the price so low so that you can penetrate into the market, but making customers to think that the product doesn't have quality. Mm-hmm. So this stage, this introduction stage, you wouldn't expect a very high sales because of so many reasons, like I just said earlier.
the price might be too high for customers to buy. Customers might not trust the kind of product you are introducing to the market because they already have the ones they trusted. Mm-hmm. And the last one is, you might even set the price so low for you to penetrate into the market, making customers think their product doesn't have the quality it should. Mm-hmm. That is the stage of introduction. Is it clear? For introduction, look at what I said. I said, this is the stage the product is introduced to the market. Sales are expected to be low at this stage, as consumers may not still be familiar with the product. Prices might be so high, as business may want to sell higher than the promotional cost. And lastly, business might set prices so low, making customers think it lacks quality. So at this stage of introduction, you don't expect a higher sale because of these following reasons. Is it clear? Then growth. Saturation. What is maturity? Now the product is well known. They are buying the product. And so at this stage, the market share is stable. Do you understand? This is the stage where the market share is what? Stable. Is it clear? Future in the revenue anymore. That means your revenue might not increase further. So at that time, you start thinking of what next to do with that product. Mm-hmm. Do you understand? So decline. This is the stage where the product decline. The fourth one. So this is the stage where the product should start seeking extension strategies. Mm-hmm. What are these type of extension strategies? Maybe to reduce the price, to repackage the product, to think of sending it abroad, and these are the type of extension strategies which we're going to talk in the next class.